Thank you, Cookie. Good morning from Europe, and also I think afternoon in Asia. So this is, I think the time is like 7 hours. So today I'd like to talk about this van der Waals layered magnetic semiconductors, and of course I'd like to focus more on this Chinese metal like chalcoholite, which is even from what you guys discussed about this halide. So I'm from Korea. Before I forget, I'd like to show our group members. Folks, he's working on as a team leader in our center, and Seok Jun is a postdoc, mainly working on the CVD and MFM and optics as well. And Jin Bao is working on this transport, and Hua is working on this material, this bulk material, and this is by CVT, and we are Youngmin Kim for this TM measurement. And we have several students Dong working on this CVT as well as transport, and Pumzu is working on this STM and STS, and Ang is working on this CVT again, and Feng is working on this MFM, and Busan work on this PM. Okay, I think everyone knows about this these popular topics and transition metal like chalcogenide, and what we have done all these TMD materials they have different structure phases, semiconducting hexagonal 2H phase, and also this octahedral metallic phase, and also this distorted octahedral phase. And for bulk material, you do have this orthorhombic and rhombohedral. And what is more interesting is that all depending on these phases, we have different physics phenomena. I think one of the key is a very strong spin of coupling, topological insulator, and also this value on it that you guys are talking about. So this is very important. I don't want to emphasize this all this one, but some examples that we have done so far in our lab, working on this phase transformation from this 2H semiconducting phase to metallic 1T prime phase. For example, using this molybdenum dietelluride, we can make many different phases, playing with this strain or external electron doping, and also even laser radiation to get this homojunction contact. So all these are the available. I think people can find some more interesting observations later. Now, one of my favorite topics is, of course, we like to grow this material. Our key target is actually whether this wafer scale, which is feasible for this for the integration of this electronics. And so for example, using this graphene, of course we can have this polycrystalline graphene, and it's also interesting by itself. But of course our we're interested in having this single crystal copper. This was done. Now talking about this even not monolayer graphene, also we're talking about this bilayer, trilayer, and also tetralayer, as well as determining all these interesting this stacking orders in the system. But of course, key case in this case is to have this silicon dilution on the copper film to control this the amount of graphene. By using this solubility of this copper in carbon in the copper film. And of course, we were able to make this not only this graphene, also this HVN, again, single crystal and wafer scale, in this case, using this liquid gold on tungsten foil. So this can be done. Not only that, also we can also have this heterostructure by growing this HVM first and the later drawing in series by this graphene, so we can have this graphene HBN stacking order in this case. So there are many things to do, and of course, so far we are talking about this key research target of these materials in terms of the CVD, wafer scale, and the single crystal. We can do play with this graphene up to layer 4 layers. We still don't know how to improve this further. And we can have this monolayer HBN graphene, HBN film. And some of them monolayer still wafer scale is tungsten disulfide and molybdenum disulfide. And there are some limited cases of this heterostructure structure. Of course, in this case, a key is this whether we can have this growth platform for wafer scale single crystal TMDs from CVD. So this is what we are working on at the moment. But here, I like to focus more on this ferromagnetism in 2D materials. One of the popular topics people talk about is the diluted magnetic semiconductor. So we are interested in having semiconductor with this magnetism further, which may be used for this spin joints later. So yeah, if you look at this just the semiconductor, of course, spin up and down, they all saturated. So we don't have this magnetic moment. But in this, if you have this magnetic semiconductor while maintaining the semiconductor, we have this spin line. In such a case, we may have this magnetic moment. Of course, once you have that, we like to go on to this gate tunable magnetic properties. Simply, we like to manipulate this magnetic moment using this gate bias. And of course, the popular subject people talk about is diluted magnetic semiconductor, because sometimes not easy to get the semiconductor as well as having this magnetic. So in the case of this magnetic dopant material in the system, we may be able to control this magnetic moment with even gate further. So the key idea in this case is whether we can have this low impurity concentration, whether we can have this long range magnetic order. But once we have that, then of course we can modulate this magnetic moment with carrier concentration in the system. Now, so far, I think we will talk about this DMS. Well-known system is manganese dopant gallium arsenide. In this case, of course, the Curie temperature is below room temperature. So people talk about many different materials to realize this high TC using even this telluride system and in the further nitride and oxides. Of course, this is either the temperature, Curie temperature is high, but the gate tunability because of its oxide, for example, is not possible. Whereas in some other places, like a tellurium system, this Curie temperature is very low. So recently, as you guys are familiar with this system, this chromium sulfide or chromium iodine and tellurium system, all, as you see, this Curie temperature is below room temperature. So our main target of the research will, of course, whether we can realize this 2D BMS material, can we achieve this high Curie temperature equivalent to room temperature, or whether a tunable magnetism can be realized or not. This is our research target. I think for your interest, you see this is one of these unresolved questions in the community. One of them certainly is diluted magnetism semiconductor, whether that's, that is possible with this room temperature. Of course, this is not possible. Since 2005, well, still we have a hard time to achieve this room temperature, Curie temperature. Now, the question with this DMS or change metal like chalcogenide, there are several choices what kind of material we have to choose. Now, we confine ourselves to have this TMDIS, molybdenum dicelluride and selenide, and also molybdenum telluride, tungsten dioxide, and so on. So certainly, because of the transition metal, certainly have this d orbitals. Whereas when we have introduced this magnetic dopant, for example, vanadium or manganese or iron, of course they certainly have this d orbitals. This is actually very different from this manganese doped gallium arsenide, where this they actually have this sp hybridization involves. So question whether this is a PDD orbital hybridization may play a role to improving this QE temperature as well as this other magnetic system. So the choice of material in our research is to choose this tungsten diselenide. It's certainly semiconducting with relatively high mobility and different from this manganese, which can be clustered in gallium arsenide. We like to have this sort of homogeneity of the material, in this case using this vanadium dopant. So there are, what are the challenges in this DMS in our case? Of course, this QE temperature over the room temperature, whether this gate modulation is possible, whether it has this long-range magnetic order in the system. Of course, without having this all these alloys in the vanadium case. So as you see from this TM, all this red color indicates this vanadium atoms. And interestingly, all these vanadium atoms are well distributed uniformly entire this system. So I think this sense compared to this manganese in this case, of course, it depends on this vanadium doping concentration, in this case 2%. So still, we see this all this vanadium are well distributed randomly in the system. So our approach is just a simple CVD. Previously, we've been working on this one using this liquid precursor approach, which is very convenient because we can, once we have this liquid precursor using vanadium and tungsten together, they are just spin tested on the substrate, and we have very uniform uniformity of all these precursors. So once we have that, of course, we simply apply and supply this selenium in the system to have this monolayer and multilayer TMD material. So in the case of this monolayer of vanadium doped and diselenide, we can have all monolayer up to 10%, but if you go over beyond 10%, some of them they are like rather dendritic, or some of these multilayer flakes over 20%. So we try to limit this below this 10% in our system. Now, if you look at this TM, we can obviously identify the presence of the tungsten atom and selenium atom, as well as this vanadium by looking at this its intensity profile. And so this filtered STM image shows all this. Vanadium is a substitutional into this tungsten, and they are well uniformly distributed. This is also a strength of this vanadium compared to this manganese doped gallium arsenide. Now, certainly, of course, the tungsten selenide is a semiconductor. So with the doping concentration, we see this high on-off ratio, and up to 1%, we still retain this high on-off ratio, which is a semiconductor. This is a p-type. But if you increase this vanadium doping concentration, then the system becomes highly degenerate. So this becomes metallic. So try to maintain our system within 10% to maintain the semiconductor. Now, how to observe this magnetic moment of the system? We use this simply this magnetic force microscope. In this case, the idea is very simple. But anyway, we do repeat the scanning of two samples of the using this tip. The first we scan it to have this morphology. Once we have that, and we use this magnetic tip for this purpose, of course, and then we repeat again. Then we see any kind of derivative of this system. We see this magnetic domain in the system, and we can see doesn't work. So here at the 0.1% of vanadium with this topology, which is just a one simple tapping mode, we don't see anything there, any you know, the difference. Whereas in the case of this MFM with a cobalt tip, and you can see there is a magnetic domain, which is a sign of this magnetic moment. So the tip is very important. So if you use this as platinum, and we do repeat this on topology and also this phase, and we see no difference at all. Whereas in the case of this cobalt tip, we can see this topology is nothing, but we can see this phase deviation in this MFM. So this is an evidence, I mean, this evidence of this presence of this magnetic moment. Now, with this temperature, of course, we can see this evolution of this MFM phase contrast, and you can see as you increase the temperature, see this sort of a line stripe, which is, we still don't know why there's a line stripe on this pattern. In the literature, so people talk about this kind of line stripe, but I mean, we still don't know the origin of this one. But it's, I would like to see this temperature dependence in our case. As temperature increases, of course, this line stripe becomes sort of smaller. So again, I think this was just a sign of this MFM negative domain. Now, if you look carefully, the temperature dependent this MFM domains, and you can see this area, we have this sort of separated phase, but as you increase the temperature, these are merged. And in this case, they are seems to be splitting in this case. So, and as you increase the temperature further, then we cannot see them clearly, the difference between these two. You can actually look at these phases at different distance of the system. You see this intensity is quite persistent up to 300K, but then after this 300K, we cannot see this kind of intensity phase deviation with distance. So this is again this I believe this is just evidence of this magnetic signal. People talk about this the new possibility of having this electrostatic response, but I mean this simply indicates with temperatures we can see this magnetic domain changes. Now, another way to prove this one, we use this, we magnetize this of the sample by having this magnet along this direction and this direction. You see this magnetic phase is modulated in the system. So this is again the evidence of this magnetic force interaction. Now, there's also a question of this, whether this sample inert under ambient conditions. Of course, because the sample is exposed in the air, they also change it. So you can see just the air exposure, we see this kind of sort of ambiguity. As you this annealing, I mean, the product, just the simple pumping in the system, and you see this phase deviation emerging. Slowly, and annealing the sample again in the system, you see this magnetic deviation is largely influencing the system. So, although there is a problem of this this air oxidation, but once we have this this annealing in the system, they can be recovered to have this magnetic domains. Now, if you look at this advanced functional calculations, you can obviously see this the presence of this vanadium near the conduction bandage, and this is certainly gives an opportunity to have this thermal engineering or gate modulation in the system. Now, this is you can obviously see this vanadium with a spin up and down. They are certainly different. So then, what's more interesting is that if you use this only tungsten around this vanadium, you can see still the spin system is still there. So somehow this vanadium influences the nearby this tungsten atoms in the system to have this magnetic moment. And if you look at this STM and also this STS, originally, if the position is far away from this vanadium, and you can see this valence band and conduction band with a large band gap in the system as expected from this existing sample. But as you approach this vanadium, of course, we can obviously see this presence of this signal of this, I mean, this impurity levels of this vanadium, which is indicated by this IS1 and IS3 as well. And but if you're a little bit far away from this vanadium, but not very far, you can see some of this tails in the system. Again, this proving that this vanadium related spin magnetic moment in the system. Similarly, of course, you can use this density of states from this density DFT calculation. They are very similar to this vanadium Doppler system. Now, of course, another issue is the gate bias. As we mentioned previously in the speaker, here in this case, by using this simply DFT calculation with this carry injection, you see the firm level changes, and you see spin system changes gradually with this carrier injection. And you can place this one exchange versus this magnetic moment. And this whole injection range, we can see this high magnetic moment because of this spin polarized of the enhanced spin polarization with a carrier density, a hole in this case, whereas in the electron carrier density, this magnetic moment is minimized. So we can see this vanadium located here and here nearby whole system supplied in the system. You see these spins are also this spin polarized, influenced by this vanadium. In the case of this low hole or electron density, this spin magnetic moment is there, but the adjacent like selenium and tungsten, they sometimes goes to zero magnetic spin magnetic moment or this anti-ferromagnetic moment in the system. So this is a very good sign that we can have this modulation. Good from theory, but you can do the same thing using the gate bias using this MFM system. Simply, we use this backgate in the MFM tip by using this silicon oxide substrate. And you can see for at the 300K with this gate modulation from hole to electron, you can see this phase deviation changes with gate bias. The same thing also at the minus 10 volt of this gate bias, we can see this temperature modulates as well as together. So all these indicates that the gate modulation can be realized in the vanadium doptons and selenide system. Whether this is a long-range magnetic order or not, in this case, if you look at the spin density of the system, of course, the vanadium is ferromagnetic in the system, and when this is very far away from this vanadium, for example, in the case of this tungsten, we still have some presence of this ferromagnetism in the system. So, although I cannot say at the moment, but the influence of this ferromagnetism from far away from this tungsten is not negligible at all. At least like at least 30% of this spin magnetic moment enhanced by this tungsten diselenide system. So the position of this vanadium very near this valence bandage. So that's also very key to have this gate modulation, because this permeable can be engineered around this valence bandage to have this spin magnetic moment modulation. Also, what is interesting is the magnetoresistance system, magnetoresistance with a magnetic field. We have this hysteresis. As you increase the temperature to 300, still is quite persistent. This hysteresis. So this again indicates this the room temperature, cool temperature can be expected from this. So I think the take-home lesson in this case, of course, this monolayer TMD can provide this room temperature ferromagnetism. Now, what about bulk? People talk about this layer dependence of the system in this chromium iodine. And in this case, we simply make this bulk sample using this CVT. And we have this small size of the sample. And you can see, at the room very low temperature, we have this VSM hysteresis up to the, at the very small vanadium doping concentration. Even in the 300 K, you can see, although this hysteresis reduced, we still see the hysteresis of the system. And what's more interesting, of course, if you do this still low temperature, but out of plane and in plane changes, you can see there is a significant contribution from both, not only this out of plane, also in plane magnetic system. So this is unlike this like the XI system or some other system, but in our case, this is a rather like a canted system in our noctons and diselenide. And of course, if you consider this uniformity of the sample by looking at the photoluminescence, within this few micrometer, we see they are quite uniform. Although we still don't know, that sometimes we often observe this this disappearance of this magnetism, which we still don't know. We have to control these samples. Now, another way to identify this spin polarization is circularly polarized photoluminescence. And if you look at this spin up and spin down, and we have this sigma plus and sigma minus, and we see the difference in the system. And because they are all related to this vanadium doped near the valence bandage, so you can see the difference between this plus and minus in the system. So this is an exfoliated monolayer tungsten tungsten diselenide, but the CVD sample. And you can see this pristine sample. We have this neutral exciton and trions because of this intrinsic P dopant. And by using this vanadium dope impurity, we do have shifted of this, not only the neutral exciton, but also this trion exciton. And we can also identify this sign of this impurity level. And if you overlapping together with this intensity, you see even they are overlapped together, and this spin up and spin down circular polarization, you can see there is a slight difference, and you can see the difference. So this is again strong evidence of this spin polarization at room temperature. So you can see this is 77K. You can see the intensity changes. Again, this is because of this valley polarization. And you can also the difference between this spin up and spin down in the impurity state. So this is somehow, it's not clear at the moment for us what's going on, but obviously we can see this this circularly polarized photoluminescence to observe this. So far, I'd like to summarize. We have this 2D van der Waals 8 magnetic semiconductor, and we see obviously this Curie temperature above this room temperature. Gate tunability is also can be realized in our system. So I think the take-home lesson in this case is to have this room temperature ferromagnetism in monolayer TM, this but also this bulk as well. I think this provides plenty of room for suspensions in the future. Thank you.